guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh, Lord, some of these days. I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to tell my mother, howdy, when I get home. Well, 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 I want to tell my mother, hey, when I shake mother hand that day, that's when I walk, oh, that milky white way, some of these days. I want to meet God the Father and God the Son. Yes, I want to meet God the Father, God the Son. Well, 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 I want to tell them all about my trouble. Then of this world I just come from, that's when we walk, oh, that milky white way. Oh, Lord, some of these days.
Soon and very soon we are going to see the King. Oh, soon and very soon we are going to see the King. Lord, soon and very soon we are going to see the King. I'm singing hallelujah, hallelujah. We're going to see the King. Well, no more crying there. We are going to see the King. Lord, no more crying there. We are going to see the King. Well, no more crying there. We are going to see the King. I'm singing hallelujah, hallelujah. We're going to see the King. Well, no more pain up there. We are going to see the King. Lord, no more pain up there. We are going to see the King. Lord, no more pain up there. We are going to see the King. I'm singing hallelujah, well, hallelujah, we're going to see the King. Well, no more dying there, we are going to see the King. Lord, no more dying there, we are going see the King. Well, no more dying there. We are going to see the King. I'm singing hallelujah, well, hallelujah. We're going to see the King. Well, soon and very soon we are going to see the King. Lord, and very soon we are going to see the King. Well, soon, very soon we are going to see the King. I'm singing hallelujah, well, hallelujah, we're going to see the King. Well, soon, very soon, we are going to see the King. Lord, soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Well, soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. I'm singing hallelujah, well, hallelujah. We're going to see the King. Well, no more crying there. We are going to see the King. Lord, no more crying there. We are going to see the King. Well, no more crying there. We are going to see the King. I'm singing hallelujah, well, hallelujah. We are going to see the King. Well, no more dying there. We are going to see the King. Lord, no more dying there. We are going to see the King. Oh, well, no more dying there. Oh, we are going to see the King. I'm singing hallelujah. Well, hallelujah. Oh, we are going to see the King. Oh, well, no more pain up there. We are going to see the King. Lord, no more pain up there. We are going to see the King. Oh, well, no more pain up there. We are going to see the King. I'm singing hallelujah. Well, hallelujah. Oh, we're going to see the King. Oh, well, soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Lord, soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Oh, well, soon, very soon, we are going to see the King. I'm singing hallelujah, well, hallelujah, oh, we're going to see the King. I'm gonna trade my earthly home for a better one, bright and fair. Christ left to repair a mansion for the children in the air. I'll join him in that land where till no sorrow can be found. When I receive a mansion, growing up crown, oh Lord, I want a mansion.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
Let's bow for one prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, we come to you this afternoon, Father God, to say thank you. Thank you, Father God, that we live here. We have another day here on earth. Try to get it right. We live up a prayer now, Father God, for the family of Brother Alonzo. Pray, Father God, for the children. Pray that you will strengthen them, Father God. Give them the strength that you see stand in need. Also, Father God, put your loving care around his wife. And help her, Father God, to remember where she saw him last. We all want to have a good remembrance of him and the way he lived. And we want the kids to stay. He lived a good life, Father God, and we pray that his family will continue with life on. We ask you all, Father God, with friends and all, we thank you. We ask you to be with us, strengthen us, wherever you sit this weekend, build us up where we're torn down. And go with us through this part of the service and all part of the service. In Jesus' name we do pray and give thanks. Let's all say amen.
Amen. And now we would have scripture from the Old Testament and the New Testament read by Brother Rodney Taylor and Brother Rodney Simmons.
Old Testament verse would be Psalm 23rd chapter, and it reads, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me lie down on green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemy. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." Amen.
Amen.
May the Lord have a blessing to the reading and doers of his word.
Amen.
I'll be reading a verse from the Gospel of John, chapter 14, 1 through 6. "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And where I go, you know, and the way you know." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are, where you are going, and how can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me."
Amen.
Amen. And now we will have a solo led by Brother Corey Williams. Corey Williams.
I've had some hills to climb. I've had some bad days and some sleepless nights. But when I looked around and I think things over, all of my good days outweigh my bad days, and I won't complain. Sometimes the clouds hang low and I can hardly see the road. I've asked the question, Lord, why so much pain? But he knows what's best for me. Even though my weary eyes cannot see, so I'll just say thank you, Lord. I won't complain. God has been good to me. He's has been so good to me than this whole world could ever be. He's been that good. He will dry all my tears away. He will turn my midnight into day. So I'll just say, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
I'll just say, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
I'll just say, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
I won't complain.
And all the congregation of God's people say, amen.
Amen.
To you, the bereaved family, the Mitchell's church family, those of you who are their friends, and you're just guests to this assembly, we gathered here this evening to celebrate a life that was well lived by Brother Alonzo Lee Mitchell. Yeah. I remember Brother Mitchell as a man of few soft words. One who loved the Lord. Yeah. He loved himself, he loved his wife, and he loved his family, his friends, and even his enemy.
Yeah.
I'm sure that Brother Mitchell will be greatly missed by all of us. But we need to realize that Brother Mitchell, he leaves behind for us a legacy of precious, precious memories of the impact that he made in each of our lives. But I want to notice a passage of scripture in the second book of Timothy, chapter 4, verses about 6 through 8. 2 Timothy, chapter 4, verses number 6 through 8. When I reflect on the life of Brother Mitchell, and I thought on what could I say that would reflect and do due diligence to the life that I know that he lived. I remember how Paul, he reflected on his own life just before leaving this world. In his second letter to his son in the gospel, Timothy, he wrote unto him, 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses number 6 through 8. He said unto Timothy, I'm now ready to be offered up. He said, and the time of my departure is at hand. But in essence, Paul told Timothy, I'm not worried about it. Why? Because I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. And I have kept the faith. And because of that, there is laid up a crown of righteousness for me, and whom the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me in that day. And not for me only, but for all who would love his appearance. Wonder what I was going to use as a topic to reflect the life of Brother Alonzo, but it was not hard. I thought about what Paul said, and I pulled a topic from that. A good fight fought, a faith well kept, and a course that was finally finished. Can we all say amen?
Amen.
A good fight that was fought, a faith that was well kept, and a course that was finally finished. You see, I am sure, again, that he will be greatly missed by all of us. But Brother Alonzo left something behind for us, and it's precious. We sang that song, Precious Memories, Unseen Angels. How they will forever linger with me. Brother Mitchell left some precious memories of all of us, because I'm sure all of us that knew him was impacted by his life upon our life. And I believe if his life would speak for him, it would speak as Apostle Paul spoke for him when he wrote to Timothy. It said, I have fought a good fight. Amen. I have fought a good fight. As a young man, I remember Brother Alonzo. As a young man who obeyed the gospel call to Christianity. You see, that's a life that requires one to fight the good fight of faith that he may lay hold on eternal life. Alonzo, he learned that. He was convicted by that. And I think he strove in his life to live according to that. And I'm sure that Brother Mitchell, as every child of God, had many fights, many struggles, and many rounds in his fight with the devil. I'm sure he did. The devil, who Peter said, 1 Peter 5 and 8, he is as a roaring lion who walketh about seeking whom he may be able to buy. I'm sure that many times and many days in Brother Alonzo's life, the devil tempted him. He caused him to struggle, and he called him to fight with himself and his foe. That's his duty. I'm sure that he tried to affect his personal life, his marital life, his social life, and especially his Christian walk with God. And let me say this, as many of us, I'm sure there was time in his life and time in his fight that Brother Mitchell, he fallen short and he sinned. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But I know him as a man who got up and kept on fighting the good fight of faith until finally, a few days ago, God sounded the bell of the last round in Brother Mitchell's fight of the good fight. And not only that, his fighting was over. He kept the faith. I know him. He left here, he was gone some 20-some years, but often when he would come home, he and I would fellowship and we would talk, and I know he was still fighting a good fight of faith. A good fight. And it was a good fight of faith. You see, the Bible teaches in Ephesians chapter 4 and verse number 4, it says there's one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. Amen? Brother Mitchell, he believed in that, he embraced that, and he strove to keep that during his life. I'm sure. You see, in Jude, say in Jude 3, that we ought to honestly contend for that faith. Brother Mitchell, as I say, he believed in that, and he obeyed, and he embraced that one faith. I am sure, in one baptism, I'm sure, as you and I have, he heard the many religious cliches saying, you got your faith, and I got mine. When it comes down to baptism, I sprinkle water on you, I pour water on you, I immerse you, when the Bible says there's one Lord, one faith, one baptism. Brother Mitchell, he contended for that. He believed that. He embraced that. And he lived. He lived according to that. That faith caused him one day, as he heard the gospel, he obeyed it, Sister Mitchell. And the Lord added him, Acts 2:47, to the church, such as he should be saved. To that body, Colossians 1:18, which Christ is the head of, and that is his body, the church. A few years after obeying the gospel, Brother Mitchell, he took his family, they moved to the state of South Carolina. That's where they lived some roughly 20-some odd years. He would come home from time to time, and he would rededicate and refellowship. He would fellowship with the church. And I'm sure that when he was in the state of South Carolina, he did the same. I know he was faithfully working. One occasion, I was called up there to preach, and Brother Alonzo was there. His children was young, his wife was young, he was young, I was young, my wife, all of us was young. But God blessed us to still be around. And we've gotten a little older but wiser. But I remember Brother Alonzo again as a man who fought a good fight. And he kept that one faith waver. And not only that, but finally, he finished, as Paul said, he finished his course. As I said a few days ago, God called him from the round, from the fight, from the ring. Say it is finished. Alonzo, Brother Alonzo has finished his course, his mission in the Christian life. Brother Mitchell, during those years of fighting the good fight and keeping the faith that led him to the finish line. The finish line, his assignment. And that assignment is the same to him as it is with all of us. Mark 12:29, it is to hear, O Israel, the Lord thy God is one Lord, and you shall love the Lord thy God with all of your heart, with all of your soul, and with all of your mind. Brother Mitchell, he embraced that, and not only did he love God, but John 4:24 says, God is the Spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. And Brother Mitchell, he faithfully worshiped God. He reverenced God. He honored God. He cherished God, and he obeyed God. Constantly, 1 Thessalonians 5:17, talking with God, or praying with God for himself, his family, and his fellow man. And not only that, but he, and worshiping and loving and honoring God, he knew that he had to have a love for all men, Galatians 6:10. He had to have and demonstrate a sure love for all men, but especially those of the household of faith. You see, and Brother Mitchell, he adhered to the scripture. He loved the Lord. He cherished the Lord. He honored the Lord. And he obeyed him. Revelation 2:10. Faithfully unto death. And God had promised him, as he promised us, a crown of life. Brother Mitchell could say, in the culmination of the conclusion of his life, as Paul said, I am ready to be offered up. At the time of my departure, my death is at hand. But I'm not worried about it. I don't need no extension. Hezekiah asked for extension. Lord, remember me. How I have walked according to your statutes and uprighteously in your sight. And God remembered Hezekiah, added to him 15 more years. Brother Alonzo didn't ask for an extension on life. I heard one of his family members, maybe his daughter, somebody told me the other day when I was talking to him, he said, I'm tired. Like Apostle Paul was saying, I am ready to be offered up. And the time of my departure, or the time of my death, is at hand. But I'm not worried. Why? Because I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. And I kept the faith. And because I fought, and let me tell you something, brothers and sisters, this life is one that is full of fights. Fighting with ourselves, fighting with our family, fighting with our friends, and constantly fighting with our foes. But Paul said, I fought a good fight. I ain't saying that I won every round, but I kept getting up, and I kept on fighting till I finished my course. And now, not tomorrow, not next year, but right now, there is a crown of righteousness that's laid up for me, in whom the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me.
Yeah.
And that thing, why? Because I fought a good fight.
Yeah.
I kept
the faith.
The faith. Yeah. And I didn't give up. I didn't fall short.
Right.
But I finished.
Yeah.
You see, it's not enough to start off doing something.
Yeah.
But to start and finish. But the Bible say the race is not to the swift, nor is it to the strong, but unto those that would hold out until the end. Brother Mitchell, he held out. I visited him in the hospital. I didn't go in there where he was because I didn't want to see him like that. But I would go with his, and pray with his family and talk with his family and comfort and encourage his family. But I would tell him, he all right. I'm not God, but it's for what I see. God makes us few to inspect us, not judge. From what I witness, he fought a good fight. He kept the faith. And thank God he finished his course. And now God got something waiting on him. He said, whom the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me in that day. He's got to stand before the judgment. Hebrews 9:27, after death, and he's got to give an account for the deeds done in his body, whether they was good or whether they were evil. But thank God, he said, the righteous judge is going to judge me.
Amen.
And if he find me felt faithful, if I hear him say, well done, I got a crown of righteous laid up for me.
Yes.
Brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, he said, not for me only, but for all who would love his appearance. How is your life with Christ today?
Amen.
What fight are you, what fight are you fighting?
Amen.
Is it the good fight?
Yes.
Of faith?
Yes.
If not, why not?
Amen.
And if not today, today, God say, if you would hear my voice, harden not your heart. Today, let the day be today.
Yes.
Accept Christ as Savior and God in your life, as Brother Alonzo did. When that time comes, you can say to yourself, your life can speak for you. I fought a good fight. I finished my course, and I kept the faith. If you're not a child of God, you should be today. Realize that one day you're going to lie prostrate just like he is, and I am too. But my question would be, in death, what would your life say? You know, we sang that song, may the life I live, the service I give, the work that I've done speak for me. He has spoke for him. What about you and I? We can help you in a way. Please contact me and let us know. Let us together bow our heads. Let us together bow our heads in prayer. Righteous God and our Heavenly Father, again we boldly bow our heads humbly before you with much thanksgiving in our heart for you blessing us with all the things that you saw was necessary to sustain us every day of our life. You blessed us. Even when we was rebellious towards you, you blessed us. Even when we would obey you, you blessed us. All because you love us so. Help us, Heavenly Father, to be grateful for all your blessings. One day we may say, as David said, what shall I render unto the Lord for all of his benefits towards me? This is what I'm going to do. I'm going to take up the cup of my salvation. I'm going to obey the gospel that he freely extended to me. And I'm going to pray my vow in the presence of all the congregation of God's people. Help us, Heavenly Father. Guide us, protect us. Keep us in your grace is our prayer. In the name of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
love me, release me, let me go. I have so many things to see and do. You mustn't tie yourself to me with tears. Be happy that we had so many years. I gave you my love and you can only guess how much you gave me in happiness. I thank you for the love that you each have shown, but now it is time that I travel alone. So grieve a while if grieve you must. Then let your grief be comforted by trust. It's only for a while that we must part. So bless the memories within your heart. I won't be far away for life goes on. So if you need me, call and I will come. Though you can't see or touch me, I'll be near. And if you listen with your heart, you'll hear my love around you so soft and so clear. And then when you too must travel this way alone, I'll reach it with a smile and say welcome home. The family of Mr. Alonzo Lee Mitchell Sr. is most appreciative for the many kind and loving expressions of sympathy that you each have shown. They ask for your continued prayers in the days to come, and may each of you continue with the blessings of the Lord. The following floor arrangements have been sent to the family. With deepest sympathy from Annie Stubbs and family, it is our prayer that God will see you through these tough times. In loving memory of Mr. Alonzo Mitchell Sr., grief can be so hard, but our special memories help us cope. Remembering you and your loved ones, today and always, Jimmy Harmon. Pray for you and your family from Rick and Linda Walker, Macon, Georgia. In loving memory of Mr. Mitchell Sr., words cannot express my love for this family. Rest in peace, my brother. I will cherish the memories and keep you all in my thoughts and prayers, Jarvis and Lillian. Your brothers and sisters in Christ at Chafe Road Church of Christ. In love and memory of Mr. Mitchell Sr., with deepest sympathies, we love you and we are so sorry for your tremendous loss. We are sending your family prayers during this difficult time. Love, Blair Logistics. With deepest sympathy, your daughter, Cotright and grandkids. Praying for your strength, your church family, Hilltop Baptist Church of Christ, James L. Hughes, minister. The family flower is given in loving memory of a loving and caring father, grandfather, husband, and friend from the family. In loving memory of Dr. Napoleon Williams, Deacon Arthur O. Parker, CEO and President, along with staff of J.W. Williams Funeral Home, is pleased to present to this family an African-American family heirloom Bible in the hope that it will serve as a source of added comfort and peace in the days to come. We are also pleased to present to this family a pictorial tribute of your loved one's life. It is our prayer that you will forever remember the many cherished memories you shared as a family. And finally, we present this memorial blanket. It is our prayer that you wrap yourself in the love and warmth that this blanket holds and may it be a constant reminder of your beloved. For anyone that is ever loved is never lost. It is our prayer that you're blessed now and always.
Resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ in the precious name.